So it's Ken O'Keefe back in Gaza. Man, what a beautiful place this. Look at this sky. Not a chemtrail in the sky. What is it with Rothschild Israel land? Why is there no chemtrails here? I can tell you, it's been a long, long road. As I said in my last video, it's been a long, long road, but a beautiful road nonetheless. The trials and tribulations are only the challenges that either make you weaker and bitter or hateful, or stronger and wiser. I chose the latter path. Not only am I blessed to be here, but my company is special company. If you don't know of Max Igan, you should know about Max. One of the things that makes it possible for me to really kind of trust somebody these days with all the defiance of trust is people who put it on the line. Max has put it on the line. He's got a massive audience in Australia and around the world. He's got his own YouTube channel. It's just fantastic. So many great videos. And this man has really, really, really been antagonistic to the powers that be and empowering to the people. And you know, something strange and funny that's just happened. Somehow, some way, Max managed to get this massive audience and no one really even knew what he looked like. He never showed his face at all, and he's only just recently come out of the closet, as it were. So here we have my brother Max here in Gaza.
Hey folks, lovely to be here. Wonderful day in Gaza. Chemtrails, no chemtrails in the sky. Fishing boats out there, interesting to see them fishing so close to shore. Of course, they're not allowed to go much further than that because if they do, the Israeli gunboats shoot at them. It's been a real education being here, folks. It absolutely has. The Palestinians are a wonderful people. Like, don't believe what you hear about Palestinians. They're not terrorists. They're beautiful people. Every person that I've met has been so kind and so friendly. It's very hard to walk past anyone without them offering you a cup of tea and taking you into their house and wanting to socialize with you. It's really fantastic. Ken and I are here building a schoolroom for the Samuni kids at the moment. If you haven't heard about the Samuni kids, I suggest you go to Ken's channel and look at the story of the Samuni family. It's absolutely shocking what's been done to these people. This is a thriving community, folks, in the face of massive adversity, And we really had a mission to get here, but it's good to be here, and I couldn't think of a better person to share this moment with.
You know, it's funny you say that, Max, because, you know, it's always been my experience, and I don't think I know a person who's come to Palestine who hasn't had the same kind of experience. When you come here, it's just enriching. How can you not feel enriched when you're dealing with people who are, on just an everyday basis, subjected to tremendous injustice and pressure? Here in Gaza, you've got 1.6 million people, over 800,000 children, over half the population are children. Parents are having to deal with these conditions that we wouldn't be able to tolerate for a day in the West. And what I'm getting to do, actually, is live vicariously through Max and relive my first experiences coming to Palestine, to Gaza. We sat there yesterday at Zainat Samouni's house with her lovely children, and she told a story that I've heard before, but you couldn't hear this story a million times and not be affected by it. What this woman and this family went through, from the husband being shot in front of the 8 kids, to her 4-year-old son being shot by the Israelis at point-blank range in the chest twice and dying over a day and a half without the Israelis allowing her to give medical attention to her son. It was just an incredible story, not to mention the 97 family members of the Samuni family that were herded into one house and then hit with rockets. I mean, I'm watching Max transform, and I can tell you for sure, coming to Palestine can only make you a better person.
I absolutely agree with that. I absolutely do. It's a really life-changing experience being here. It really is. You cannot describe the feeling of the place. It's surreal being here after everything you hear about it. It's absolutely surreal. And I can't think of a better way for people to find out the real situation of the world than to come to Palestine. We have to free this place. We have to free Palestine. We absolutely have to do it.
And on that note, we'll have more to say while we're here in Gaza. And I just want to say to all the good people out there, love and respect to you. Just know, also, before I forget, how could I forget that? The Palestinian hunger strikers, two of the brothers, one is going to be released at the end of his administrative detention, Hassan Safadi, in October. Alhamdulillah, beautiful, fantastic. It should have happened a long time ago. And then Samer El-Bark, He is going to be released, but I have to say, he's being exiled to Egypt, and I believe he's going to head off to Pakistan because his wife is there. That's a bunch of bullshit. That man is a Palestinian, and he has every right to live in Palestine. The fact that he was locked away for years and years without any due process of law only shows what kind of a racist, genocidal, criminal state Israel is. And that man is welcome in Palestine, and of course every Palestinian knows that. So go ahead and release him, Israel, but he's going to come back to a free Palestine much sooner than you would like. There are still two hunger strikers who are going, and they are in serious danger of dying. These people, these brothers, are your brothers. They're my brothers. This is why I'm on a hunger strike on day 14 of my 30-day hunger strike minimum, and I shall keep going. Let us be resolute. Let us know that these are just like our mother, our father, our brother, our sister, our son, or our daughter. Let us look at them like we would look at our own blood family members, because these brothers are going to die if Israel is allowed to murder yet more Palestinian people. No due process of law, no fucking justice in this goddamn country. And until this world is ridded of this polluting factor of the Zionist racist regime, we will not have peace in this world. The way of Palestine is the way of the world. So let us make sure that justice comes to Palestine sooner rather than later.